all day, watching movies and texting me about those movies. Do you even use the drum set you have anymore, or is it just there?
I like recommending.
Yeah, films. You write books and scripts about the outside world, and you don't even go outside, Jacob.
I've had my good share of the outside world already. It's been an okay 15 years.
You're 16, get over yourself.
Exactly. Look at me. I'm 16 and I've managed to get great hair, Sam. I was having a much better time when you were in my house.
Doing what? Sitting in your room, acting all solemn, listening to the same song over and over again?
Car radio's a good song.
There's more to this world than your home, Jacob. You've changed since we broke up.
No. I changed when the one person who loved me left. That's when I changed.
She wasn't the only one who cared about you, Jacob. I still care about you. You had to mourn, and I let you mourn. But after that, you didn't have time for me or anyone else. Jacob, we miss you, the old you. I mean, for Christ's sake, it's been a year already.
369 days to be exact. And I don't give a fuck about time. Time doesn't matter when everything else starts to stop.
Everything stops so that you could think. So that you could realize that what happened is okay, but what you're doing to yourself is not.
I haven't stopped thinking. I don't think I'll ever be.
No one said you had to stop thinking.
Look, I'm going to Central Park to meet a friend. You can come along and get some fresh air for once.
Industrialization these days, there's no such thing as fresh air. Besides, last week I went to get some paper towel. That was my 5 minutes of fresh air. I will.
You were saying?
It's in the cupboard.
No, the one by your knees.
You're in your boxers.
Leave.
You see these keys?
Where'd you get those?
Your mom.
Leave.
Sam told me to check up on you. She and I are worried about you. You're over here tearing yourself up apart over something that happened over a year ago.
369 days, actually. I'm physical, I'm active. You stand in my push-up area. Don't stand in my push-up area.
Jacob, you still have jokes. The only thing is, they have no delivery. It's like a zombie turned into a comedian.
I mean, I am dead, so... I told you I was fine. Why are you still here?
Physically, but maybe not mentally. Bro, you're about to eat milk with cereal in your boxers and watch Schindler's List. This is the most depressing thing I've seen in my entire life. And I've been to boot camp. You need to get out more. Like, a lot more.
How was it? Was it fun? Was it worth you leaving me after?
I didn't want
to. You left me! You left me when I need you the most!
If I remember correctly, you had the choice to leave, but you left anyway. I thought we were bros, right? Right?
Yeah.
So why'd you leave?
I needed to get away. I couldn't breathe. School wasn't doing it for me. I felt like I wasn't good enough, smart enough. So I said, hey, I'm big. I'm strong. Why don't I join the army and fight for my rights? I needed some sort of boost in my life. Feel like I wasn't wasting my time. It was killing me.
I'm sorry.
Jacob, when your mom was killed, me and my family was devastated. She was like a second mother to me and my siblings. I remember in elementary school, she used to drop you off, and we used to play video games, or have sleepovers, and she would make them peanut butter cookies. God, they smelled and tasted so good. They were so tender. She would always put love in the little things like you. We all felt your pain after she died. I remember when I went to camp. I cried for that week straight. They called me River Boy.
You left without even saying goodbye. That's what hurt the most. That's when I needed you the most. You just left.
I'm sorry. When Sam told me what happened, I just couldn't see you like this. I realized you needed a friend, a brother. Someone who you could share ideas with, your thoughts upon the world.
Thanks, but I have my notebook for those achy, itchy feelings. But
why won't you open up to me? Sam? Or your father?
My father? My father's on the other side of the world in a business meeting, too busy to talk to me. And he didn't even like my mother.
Just because they got a divorce, it doesn't mean that he doesn't care about you or her.
Clyde, I'm content with my life right now. I don't need to vent to anybody. I'm not really into that. It's just me.
You wasn't saying that when Sam broke up with you.
Excuse me?
Oh. Where's the Pop-Tarts? You know, you always used to have the s'mores one. I know you have them, because every time you went out, you got the s'mores one. So you better have the s'mores one. God.
Tell you, but you had to tell me what you said before first.
You wasn't saying that when Sam broke up with you.
I don't know what that means.
It means you were saying nonsense like, bro, I loved her, and she broke up with me. Me. How could she? Remember? Arrogant Jacob.
who managed to fall in love at 15.
You think that's funny? I cried because I lost the only two people who loved me.
Oh my god. You didn't lose Sam, and you definitely didn't lose your mom. She's always gonna be there.
I guess.
You need to stop guessing, and you need to start knowing. Because there's gonna be time in life where you need to know yourself. I'm surprised you lasted this long. Because you're like the most social and antisocial person at the same time. It's like you know you have to interact with people, but then again you don't. Bro, I'm here. I'm here to help you fight your demons. Just gotta help me help you.
But just the one to be.
Because of that statement, I know you know I'm right. And no, I do in fact have someone to be. My cousin wants me to hang out, so I have to leave. Oh, if you remember, I'm a photographer, and I have a client in Central Park, so after, me and Sam are gonna go chill, so if you wanna come, you can come.
You and Sam in that park?
Yeah, it used to be our spot. Me, you, Sam, and the baseball field.
Yeah, you, me, Sam, we used to play baseball, but we didn't have any mitts, so you were always scared of catching the ball. That was fun.
Just hit me up if you want to talk or whatever, okay?
Yep.
You gonna be alright?
Yeah, I promise.
Alright.
See you later.
Mom? Mom. Mom.
Yes, I was sitting over there, and I saw you wandering about confused and scared. Then you just fell to your knees and screamed, Mom. It's kind of my duty as a Boy Scout to help you, you know?
So that's how that works. I mean, thanks for the pizza and all, but I should probably get Ben back.
Yes, sir, you don't look like you're in a position to be getting up. You look like you haven't been up for days. Just chill.
That's because I haven't. That was not a good idea.
Told you. Here, have some water.
Thanks. So what's your name?
Brian.
Nice to meet you, Brian. I'm Jacob.
So is that true, what you said?
Was what true?
About not coming out.
Yeah, this is the longest I've been out in months.
It's weird, because my grandma, she's the exact same way. She still thinks the Nazis are after her. Pretty ridiculous, if you ask me.
That is pretty ridiculous.
So, why the shelter?
Traumatic experience.
Got it. I remember when I was becoming a Boy Scout, and he asked us why we wanted to become one. And everybody had these traumatic experiences that helped them, and I was left with nothing. All I knew was besides wanting to just generally help people, I didn't have much of an experience to help me give me that drive, that push. I'm not trying to like be disrespectful, but I don't think that staying indoors is helping you. I just think it let your traumatic experience hold you instead of push.
Yeah, that's what that was.
Some good pizza. Aaron knows so close to me. Guess I should go out more, huh?
You should go jogging. It's, in my opinion, the most freeing thing. Jogging and music.
Thanks, Sam. Maybe I'll do just that. And thanks again, because you made me feel comfortable, and I really haven't felt that way in a while, so thanks, Brian.
All I know is that as long as I help at least one person, I did a good job. Good night, sir.
Have a nice night, bud.
Jacob, I know you're in there. You couldn't possibly be anywhere else. Jacob, open up. Come on. Jacob?
Why are you at my home so early?
I was in the neighborhood.
It's 8 a.m. and you just happened to be in the neighborhood. Why are you really here, Sam?
To talk.
Can I jump in the shower before we talk?
Ha ha ha, sure you can. It's your house, isn't it?
Lately, I haven't been noticing.
More ones?
They're in the cabinet above the sink! Scenes when nothing's working out for Craig. That's funny and cute. Thank you.
So again, if this was a touching romantic story, we'd obviously fall in love and she'd say all the wise, beautiful things that can only be learned in life's twilight or whatever. And then she'd die in my arms. Again, that's not what happened. She just got quieter and unhappier.
So who are you?
I think I still love you.
For real?
You love me?
For real?
Yeah, that's why I couldn't sleep at all last night, because I was thinking about you and your well-being, and that's why I'm here so early, because I couldn't sleep at all, Jacob.
You love me. Come into my house and you say you love me. I don't think I could accept that love.
Jacob, you're being ridiculous. Just listen to me.
You're insane.
I'm insane?
Yeah.
You're the one who sits in your room all day watching movies. Jacob. I didn't mean to. Jacob, I...
Please leave.
Jacob!
You look so young.
I know, honey. In death, you take the most beautiful form.
I miss you so much.
I know, but I had to go.
No, you didn't, Tom. You didn't have to go.
Everything happens for a reason, sweetie. You are so much stronger than this, Jacob. You are so much more than just these two rooms. Don't shelter yourself from the world. The world needs you.
You always talked about movies and film and writing and how you always wanted to make your own one day. Every time you saw a movie when you were little, you always said, "Mommy, Mommy, I'm going to make a movie just like that one day." And you will. I count on
you. I can't. Not without you being beside me. Teaching me about life. I can't.
I've taught you enough, my son. My only son. And now you have to learn from experience. And you can't do that by staying here in the nest. You're my baby bird, and I want to see you grow up into the full, mature bird. Meant to be.
I love you, Mom.
I love you too, Jacob.